So August 3rd, 2014, I lost them in that chemtrail sky up there. Look how gray the sky has become. It's a light blue gray. And that's not natural sky. It's like a white mist inside the sky. There was a spray bastard, I call them. That's exactly what they are, spray bastards up there. I can't see on this viewfinder. There's two wire power lines up there, and it was in right in between there is going southwest. The pattern they spray generally. But look above the trees, look at the gray in the atmosphere. You know, we breathe this stuff. You know, I've been out here a lot and I've been tired a lot as a result, and it's not because I've been out. That has a little bit to do, but you know, my God, these people aren't stupid. I mean, you keep thinking about Republican, Democrat. They're not stupid. They know exactly what they're doing. Don't let them ever lie to you and say, well, I didn't know, I didn't, or I forgot. They don't. Okay? Are you people so stupid that you'll believe anything anybody tells you that you elected, which you really didn't elect? Believe it or not, you have to look into some of this. There's so much of it. It's out there, though. If you have internet, before they shut it down or they take it over, look it all up. This is not, when you see United States, that's not our country. I don't care what you think. You're not part of the, well, you are, but you're not subject to the United States. You are supposed to be a free person born in the United States of America. The Constitution was rewritten by the 41st Congress in 1871. And let me back up a little. The Constitution was illegally rewritten by the 41st Congress in 1871. Look up the Act of 1871 when they made Washington D.C. the federal government, when they made that sovereign 8x8 or 10x10 square. What are you going to call it? Like Vatican, whatever you want to call the Vatican. It's sovereign, that land. And then the states illegally, you know, through it all goes by the color of law again, which if it's not written in the Constitution, like Ron Paul kept screaming, I'm like, oh, the Constitution. You know, that was the basis of this country. And, back in the 1700s when we first were formed as a republic, constitutional republic, someone made a comment, says, is this a democracy? It's a republic, if you can keep it. But see, most people are like, oh, blah, 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 you know, and now it's getting to the point where your rights are really going to start mattering, but you really don't get it yet. You still think that the United States is the country you belong to, because at birth, your birth certificate is an announcement, and it's really detailed. Like I said, it sounds very crazy, because most people don't want to believe the truth. They would rather believe a fabricated story that sounds good. You know, when people start talking like myself, people get ridiculed. And you wonder why they get ridiculed? It's because those in power understand that knowledge is power. And the more you know, the more powerful you will be. So if you want to laugh this off, you know, you can do it. But you know what? I'll fight with the rest of my life to remain a free person. I was born a free person, and I am a free person. I do not belong to the corporate United States. I'm a free person of the United States of America, which has its bad things when it destroyed the nations of the Indians here. But regardless, to go off on another tangent, that's a whole new thing. But it happened. We conquered, the settlers conquered the lands illegally, technically. And now they're going to push in the illegal aliens. Everybody's bitching about that. They did the same thing back in the 1600s and 1700s with the American Indian or the the natives that were here. So when we bitch about that stuff, you got to think about that. But again, that's all a side story. That's another thing to distract and keep people divided all the time. The main subject everybody needs to stay divided is we are born a free person to the United States of America. You are not a citizen of the United States unless you allow it to be. You do not have to have a driver's license unless you're committing commerce upon the roadways. The roadways are bought and paid with your taxes that you've been voluntarily paying since you were old enough to work, I guess. But again, everything I say, I don't take my word as being it, and I'm a nut. Look it all up. You'll find, of course, you're going to find stories that'll say just the opposite, and they'll give reasons for it. But if you do enough research and you check deep down, you'll see what I'm saying is the absolute truth, okay? I might be slightly off, but nothing of substance. Okay? You're born a free person to the United States of America, and you become a citizen of the United States, and your birth certificate has a lot to do with that, and the corporate, the corporation that this is what you belong to unless you investigate and you change things. But see, no one's going to do anything for you. Remember that. You ever hear nothing's easy? Nothing that's worth anything is easy? People fought and died for freedom in this country. Now it's your turn. You can do the same thing, or you can roll over and piss yourself and say, well, I'm a citizen of the United States. The most powerful corporate, the most powerful corporation on the planet, which is exactly what it is. It's a very powerful corporation. We're going to get some rain later, perhaps. There's a rain dove. So it's getting the 90s today, but again, I started out with the skies because, you know, they're systematically spraying. They've been doing it since the 60s and 70s, I'm sure. But people are starting to take note. They're changing their formulas. Before, you used to see white lines all throughout the sky, and then they widen over the period of time. The sky should have been a darker blue, almost the color, a darker blue than this swimming pool right here. That's what that sky should look like. Not gray, not a grayish blue even. It's a shade of blue. And they sprayed. Like I said, I went and got the camera when I saw the jet, the spray bastard up there spraying going southwest. And it's up above all that crap because that stuff's high up in the atmosphere. You breathe it. It comes down and gets rained down into the food. We plant our own heirloom vegetables the best we can. We got the poison toxics and shit from the sprayers. But, you know, it's better than the crap you're going to get at China Mart. And yes, it is. Don't believe for one second they got your best interest. That's, they have absolutely the opposite. If you listen to your so-called politicians talking, if you listen to everything they say and take just the opposite, that's exactly what they're doing. There'll be little actions in the public eye for you to see, and then they'll turn around and do just the opposite. So, you know, more and more people are finally starting to wake up. Thank goodness for that. But I look at my videos, I used to have like 300, 400, 500 views on a video, you know, now I get like 5. And I don't know if that's YouTube blocking it, or if I'm not putting down the right tags or whatever. I'll just start putting a lot of tags on all my videos and see if I get more views. But like I said, I cuss on a lot of them. You know what? I'm mad. You should be mad too. If you're not, well, you know what? You are a part of the problem. That's why we're as bad as we are right now. So, either start doing things, and when I hear shots from over there, y'all know that something is starting to go on. Otherwise, I've got about a little over a quarter mile view all around my house. Have about a mile in view over east of me, mile west, just over a quarter mile on all the other two directions. So, anyway, you know, if they wanted me, they could get me. They know where I'm at. I've got fingerprints on record. Oh, well, whatever. I was stupid, and I've learned. The thing is, if you've been arrested or whatever, you're in the system, but you can learn from that. I'm trying to learn the best to do for my family.